greenhouse right now, we have annual beans from drought-prone areas. So it's our acutifolius beans. That's a drought-tolerant, heat-tolerant bean native to southwestern United States. And some filiformis, which is a wild relative of beans. So these in particular were just collected and they're to add to our wild tepary bean collection. And so they're from southwestern New Mexico on the border of Mexico, extremely hot, extremely dry growing conditions. And we're excited about the tepary bean wild relatives because they can cross with cultivated tepary beans and add a little more of that heat stress, drought stress tolerance. And the way that tepary's avoid heat and drought stress one way is they have a really fast growing cycle. And so they're quick to germinate and quick to mature. And they invest a whole lot of their energy in seed yield. So they have a relatively high harvest index compared to some of the other bean crops that we have. One of the other beans, lima beans, that also tends to have a lot of heat and drought stress tolerance, they do it in a different way. Lima bean is a much more vigorous, larger plant. It has a bigger root system, it has bigger vines, and so rather than maturing fast, what it does is it escapes transient stress by just dropping its flowers and then producing more of them. And so both lima beans and tepary beans could be useful depending on what environmental stress you want to deal with in the future. And the seeds from them have a similar nutritional profile to common beans, which are already a big part of our diets. A little tepary bean botany lesson. The seam on both sides of the pods is very distinct. The flower looks a lot like a common bean flower, but if you look at the base of the flower where the bracteoles are, which would kind of look like two little leaves hugging the base of the flower, you don't really see them there. And if we were looking at a common bean flower, the bracteoles are rather large and obvious. When the pod shatters, it opens and then spirals. That's part of the seed dispersal mechanism, which is wonderful for wild plants because they get to plant their seeds, but you don't want that in domesticated plants because when you go to harvest, you end up with your seeds all over the field. And I'll grab some seeds and they'll be pigmented and smaller than the domesticated seeds. So these just look like little pebbles. Here is a domesticated tepary bean. So they have larger pods and often white flowers. Those are two of the domestication syndrome traits. And we'll look at the seeds will be larger. They're coming from larger pods. Sometimes they will grow feral in the desert too.